It is the final home game of the regular season for the Anaheim Ducks at Honda Center. There will be more, though. As the Ducks know, they are on their way to the Stanley Cup playoffs for the fourth straight year. For the Winnipeg Jets, it's the last road trip of the season before they start looking ahead to next season.
Ryan Kesler, one of the issues they have had as of late, they spent a lot of time working on it in practice, sorting out the opposition's rush attacks. It's been a little bit of an issue for the Ducks.
Manson and out center ice. Ducks regroup quickly. Silverberg takes the feed, tees it up, in and out of the glove of Hutchinson.
Yeah, first difficult save of the game for Michael Hutchinson.
Perry keeps it in at the line. Gets it back as it was blocked. Back for Getzlaff, and a good save by Hutchinson. It was deep, but he got in the way.
I think this puck was going in the net. It actually, I thought it hit post, but it actually hits Melchiori.
In that trade for Andrew Ladd from the Chicago Blackhawks. Long lead pass to Stewart. He's able to lean in and get the shot away, but on the back check, Melchiori had an angle on it. But sometimes the front office has to step in. Nice move by Ehlers. Save Gibson, but he didn't corral the rebound, and it's just set wide.
Boy, and that was Bufflin right down on the doorstep. Puck comes in, the point shot. Bufflin stationed in front of the net, and he just chops a short backhander just wide of the post.
56.
Real good play by Nikolai Ehlers. You see how mobile.
A struggling penalty kill for the Jets. They're 25th in the league. Rebound to Perry off the post shot from Getzlaff, and it's 1-0.
The one-timer is hammered, and I mean hammered, by Getzlaff. Rips it off the crossbar. Watch the rebound come out to Corey Perry. Does a great job. Hits him in the shin guard. Sits there. He taps it home.
Staying on the outside of him. He got it into the middle, and there's Ehlers again, and a big save by Gibson.
A great play by Blake Wheeler. I mean, he spins off a check in the corner, right-handed shot to a left-handed shooting Nikolai Ehlers. So it's right in his wheelhouse.
And Adam Lowry spins to center and into the Anaheim zone. Drops it off, coming in late for Meistroff. That one off the mask of Gibson. He hit him right in the mind.
Lowry does a good job to swipe that puck into the middle. Meistroff snaps it. Gibson feels it hit him in the mask, but obviously loses sight of the puck. His mates come out to his rescue, but a real nice stop.
Now Burmistrov joins the play, and pass intercepted by Getzlaff. He'll send Cogliano away shorthanded. In, and a big blocker save by Hutchinson.
Well, that's a great stop by Michael Hutchinson. Boy, he read that perfectly. It's the dreaded backhand lined pass into the middle. Getzlaff intercepts. Cogliano in alone. And look at the positioning of Hutchinson here. I mean, that is perfect. Anytime a goaltender is fielding a shot and his heels or his toes are at the top of the blue paint, there is not much to shoot at.
Andrew Kopp leads it ahead into the Anaheim zone, but no further than the line. And Perry the other way with Getzlaff. Back for Perry off the stick of Armia, just over top of the goal. To Scheifele, waits for the trailer, it's Wheeler. Back for Scheifele, looking for Ehlers, far post, and Gibson stepped out to disrupt it. Gives it to Wagner. You can hear him screaming, he got 10, so Wagner just throws it into the crease. And Hutchinson nearly botched it.
Yeah, he took his eye off that puck. He spins off the hit.
Perry curls into the middle, finds space, finds Botman, and a save by Hutchinson, but he couldn't find it. He got the blocker on it, but he didn't know where it was. It was just laying to his left.
Well, we'll watch the pass again by Corey Perry to Sammy Botman, and he just rips it off the outside of the net. Does not miss by much, but could not pick that short side top corner. Boy, it's off the post,
off the inside of the post. Their fourth power play of the game as Getzlaff steps off the boards, nudges it down low, and it's batted out of midair by McGinn. And Hutchinson again hangs on.
Yeah, he's in the right spot. Jamie McGinn, since coming over, has done a lot of this. You know, within five feet of the blue paint, that's where he gets all of his best work done.
Stafford to oppose him this time. The Jets come away with it, and they tip it in! Dano in front with the redirect, and it's a tie game with 3:46 to go.
It was a real smart shot by Jacob Trouba, and he is wide open for the redirect. Hits the top of his stick and goes up in the air. John Gibson's trying to get close to Dano, but he can't, and the redirect is perfect. So the offensive zone faceoff won.
Has Ehlers with him, drops it off. Ehlers behind the net, hits the brakes. brings it in front off of Perry as the horn sounds, and we will go to overtime. Tied at one, Botman measures the situation as the Ducks change. Great breakaway pass, gets lots in, backhander. It's underneath Hutchinson, and now it's in front of him and played back the other way by the Jets.
There's Vatanen just in front of his own goal line, and there's Getzlaf, sneaks in behind the Jets' defense off of the bench. Boy, he had space. He just opened up the path wide.
Win for Scheifele, and Paul Postma has it stripped away by Silverberg. Silverberg walks in front, tried to stuff it under Hutchinson, and he covers up. And he doesn't have enough gas left in the tank to get through all the Jet defenders. Now lost his stick as Wheeler brings it the other way. He's got Bufflin with him, shoots, and it's in the net. It went off of Gibson. Cogliano tried to rescue it, and I think he inadvertently knocked it in.
And it just has the steam to trickle over the line. Here's the shot, crook of the elbow, rolling towards the back. Cogliano can't fish it out. And the Jets shock the Ducks in overtime.
Wheeler's 24th of the season snaps a six-game regular season losing streak and a 10-game losing streak to the Anaheim Ducks. They trailed all night, but the Jets score inside the last 4 minutes of regulation, and then Wheeler is the hero in overtime by just enough.